Hey, everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Coming up, we'll see fourth-year quarterback Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys as they take on Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. With that, let's get up to the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. We're standing by for the call. Our Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly as they get ready to match up with the Dallas Cowboys. Calling the action from up top, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis with you. We got an NFC East matchup here, CD. The most difficult division year to year to really predict. In fact, no team has repeated as division champ since 2004, 15 years ago.
And that was the Eagles, correct?
Yeah.
They went back to back. Well, let's be honest about it. The way that these teams match up, the way that they draft, all trying their best to win their division, very similar styles. Eagles won the Super Bowl not that long ago. Washington, with good health, they were winning the division last year late in the season. How about New York with the Giants trying to make their move? And, of course, Dallas won the division a year ago. But this division is so interesting with Saquon Barkley in New York. Did you know that the caddy of Tiger Woods wore Saquon Barkley's jersey underneath his caddy outfit at the Masters in 2019 when Tiger won for the first time in a long time? Let's be honest about it. Saquon Barkley, he's pretty popular.
Right there.
There we go. Pac-Man. With 20!
Better bring it.
Hey, 57.
Get that! Now a two-time 1,000-yard rusher for the Bears. This is Jordan Howard. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. Xavier Woods, the free safety, up to make the tackle. Quickly now, a look at the Eagles' offensive starters.
Two-time All-Pro center Jason Kelce is one of the most athletic centers in the league. In fact, he went to the University of Cincinnati as a walk-on linebacker before converting to the offensive line. Can pull, trap, get out in front of runners in any situation. And one of the more intelligent centers in the league as well, handling all of their line calls.
That one, a first down pickup of 8.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Throwing on first is Wentz. He's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and 1. It's a second down run with Sanders. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
Good work, boy. Let's go.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you.
5-9, 5-9.
Check 99. Hey, alert 3, alert 3.
It's
a give to Howard. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
Your trip is here.
And now the defense for Dallas.
And there's linebacker Leighton Vander Esch, who was so impressive as a rookie in 2018. Many thought Dallas should have opted to pick a wide receiver at that spot. Turns out they made the absolute correct choice. A 2018 Pro Bowler who's only going to get better.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Wentz off the fake handoff to Howard. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it.
19 yards the pick up there. Move the chains.
Well, they're piecing together a nice drive to start this one. Seems pretty scripted and pretty successful so far.
And I think they did it without our help. Because you remember when we sat in the production meeting with them to talk about this, and hey, you know, how are you guys going to come out of the gate? I know I offered my help with a few plays, and they didn't seem to want it.
I didn't offer mine.
You know, you were the smart one. Whatever they're doing, though, it's working really well.
Go, go.
280!
54.
Kill.
Check.
On first and 10, here's Wentz. Steps away to his left. Touchdown, Eagles! And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone. They do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves sticking in the end zone on a running play.
On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. He's got it, and the Eagles lead it 7-0. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it was capped off by a 12-yard touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Cowboys under head coach Jason Garrett as they get set for their first opportunity. They'll be led out by the former Mississippi State product, the mobile quarterback Dak Prescott. So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Here's Prescott. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Here's the man who's led the league in rushing twice in 3 seasons, Ezekiel Elliott. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 11 yards there, first down. Couple of nice carries back-to-back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare-bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? 5 or more yards each time, that's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, and it's 2nd down. And we peek at the defense now for Philadelphia.
Playing in his 11th season in the NFL is defensive back Malcolm Jenkins, who entered with the New Orleans Saints as a cornerback before shifting back to safety, where he's had his best years. Terrific football IQ, tremendous tackler, can also guard receivers in the slot.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on 2nd and 10. The give is to Elliott. And able to work his way down to the 16. 2nd down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to 3rd and 3 now.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Ready for the second quarter, and it's our visitors with the football as they've got it with a 1st and 10. First down, Prescott. That's complete right around the 8. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they worked on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. 8 yards on the touchdown pass, and the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game.
An excellent, long, sustained offensive drive, and now they can look across the field and see a defense that looks a little bit beaten down. Right now, as an offensive coordinator, you're thinking to yourself, can I dial up the knockout punch?
Brett Maher on for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays. And it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This is taken at his 4. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line.
Let's go, boys. Bring it up.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tumble.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3 and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
They'll begin the drive with Howard. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Now here's a throw right side taken in by his tight end. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. A gain of 13. It's a 1st down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
On 1st down, they run with Howard. Try to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. Officially no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, 60 yards. And the Eagles have taken the lead. So that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise, because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. Elliott good with a PAT, and that makes the score 14-7. A drive there of just four plays. The result, Philadelphia in the end zone. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away.
Come on now, let's go!
Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. They trail a one-score deficit 14-7 as they come up first and 10. So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They start on the ground with Elliott. Oh, he sheds himself free. Touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, 75 yards. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just one play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
Extra point by Marr, up and good. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. One play, 75 yards, 6 points. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Wentz now on first down. And complete to Zach Ertz. Now he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism. Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Wentz. He finds Aguilar over the middle. The completion good for 3 and it's second down. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through all that traffic, and people wanting to put a little contact on it. Really well done.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver, and that'll make it third down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. The Eagle passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
I'm a great 57.
I'm going to run you over. Check safety, check safety.
Listen.
Again, it's Wentz. He's going to fire one deep. And this is caught inside the five. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the five-yard line. 33 yards that time. Well, it's one thing to grab it with one hand, but when you make a catch of that distance, quite another.
Yes, sir. I mean, that one right there, we keep talking about the high-flying antics that we're seeing from receivers nowadays. Doesn't matter what spot they start in. But when it actually does happen in the heat of battle, brings me right out of my seat.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
Here we go.
A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. A four-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles have moved out in front.
Well, we got a little bit of everything on that run. Offensive line creating some space. But how about the guy running behind his pads into the end zone?
What does that mean when a guy says running behind his pad? It
means that he's going to be a physical runner. That way he's able to use his shoulder pads, his forearms, anything to ward off people to power his way forward.
Elliott on for the extra point. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. That time, a six-play drive. And finishing it off with a touchdown run was Jordan Howard. Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big time John. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. And on the left side, he's got Witten. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Throwing again on second down. Prescott looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Elliott. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one good for 20 on the catch and run. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Here we go. Line eight.
Yeah, right there. 54 Mike.
Come on. You better bring
it. Prescott looks to throw on first. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. Just his second incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it, because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Dancing to his left. He may try and run for this. And he slides to avoid the hit. It's a gain of 12, and the Cowboys pick up the first.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
From the red zone now, Prescott. Well, that one sailed a bit, but the catch is still made. 11 more on that one and another first down. Prescott down. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Back and forth, we win in that first half. This has certainly been an entertaining one to watch thus far. So let's get right back out to it as we'll rejoin our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three.
Keep playing hard.
Out come the Cowboys now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. On second down, it's Elliott. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
Watch 54, watch 54. I'm coming after you.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of 35.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover 1. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. On first and goal, Howard. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
Now from the 7, here's second and goal. To throw is Wentz. Flush to his right. This will be caught at about the 5. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 5 yards that time on the completion. And now it's third and goal.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
A big play to start the drive got him in this position, but this defense has held firm since, and now it's third and goal. Wentz now to throw. Got a man open. It's Ertz. Touchdown, Philadelphia. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Eagles add 6 to their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, the second half, no matter what, whether it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever, this was a big score to start the second half.
Elliott now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So that drive, 4 plays, and it was capped off by an Eagles touchdown. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
They go to Elliott again, and down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far. And you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. A first down carry by Elliott. He takes it down to the 42, a 5-yard run.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott. Incomplete. Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, and it's 3rd and 5. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Going right side, he has Witten. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Here now, Brett Maher. He hit from 62 in his rookie season of 2018. This will be spotted just shy of midfield. A 59-yard attempt. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Of course, the door for Maher was opened after a little bit of a surprise move, the Cowboys letting go of Dan Bailey last year.
Yeah, Maher took over in the preseason. He's from Nebraska via the Canadian Football League, where he kicked for 4 years. And I saw him personally make 2 game-winning field goals last season against Detroit and in Atlanta.
Carson Wentz, along with his offense, heading back out there for their next possession. He has been consistent, hasn't he? He played well in the first quarter, good second quarter, and now continuing that here in the third.
And that's the word that they're always seeking from the guy taking the snaps, is consistency. Taking care of the ball, making sure it gets to the right people, no errors, right? Not turning it over, and just doing all the right things. That's leadership, and it inspires confidence in a team.
Yeah, been a good leadership and a good distributor.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find DeSean Jackson that time, and it's third down. Maybe a little over-anxious in the pocket there. He just didn't look comfortable on that throw.
No, he didn't, because it wasn't his normal fluid delivery. And I think you might have had it right. Wasn't really confident with what he saw downfield and almost felt like he wanted to pull that one back.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Those passes out that far wide always make you hold your breath a little bit. Felt like it was in the air for a while.
What it does is allows a defender to gain some ground, come from a long distance, and have a chance to affect the pass.
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. There. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Last year, Dak Prescott had three fourth-quarter comebacks, and he's in search of another one right now. On second and 11 now. Prescott got an open man, the tight end Jarwin. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Dak finding his tight end Witten, and the Cowboys have a first down. Fourth quarter, every drive's so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it. When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up 4th down.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. The Cowboys will go. Prescott, and this is caught. Amari Cooper. And he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on 4th down. 4th down trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
A good-looking drive for the Cowboys so far. It's a first down. Here's Prescott. They'll roll him out right. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. He was looking to get it to Allen Hurns that time, and it'll bring up third down. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. That's going to set him back 5 yards. So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and 7. Now Prescott on fourth down. Going to take a shot for Gallup. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that, because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to 4-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. But they can thank their defense for another stop, and now look at the score, where they've got the football. They're looking pretty good.
They're looking excellent, because now you're thinking to yourself, let's just take some time off the clock, work it down, and of course, you put another touchdown on the board, and you pretty much say bye-bye to this one.
Play calling here can be a little bit more conservative because of the lead.
A little bit more conservative. The biggest thing, everyone understands how to get the ball downfield and how to stay in bounds and make sure the clock keeps running.
10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now, I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And the scoreboard on their side, they're just looking to melt away these final couple of minutes and put this one in the left-hand column. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that can be the make or break difference on a play. This time he had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and 1. On the handoff, this is Howard. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Jordan Howard, his second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those 2 TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have 2 touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. five plays there on that drive. And finishing it off with a touchdown run was Jordan Howard. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end.
Hit from behind, and he's going to be driven down. Fletcher Cox, the former Mississippi State Bulldog, ringing the cowbell there on the sack.
We've been around.
Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Nigel Bradham. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And checking the timeouts, they do have two defensively, but no real need to use them as they're not going to be able to stop the clock after that. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down. They're still throwing the football here, and obviously the incompletion stops the clock. That's a bad thing.
Feels to me like they're just keeping them honest on defense, because you know they're going to stack the line of scrimmage and try and stop them.
Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Leighton Vander Esch wreaking havoc with a sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target. Incomplete. It's rare that a receiver of his caliber would drop one pass, but that's now two times he's had his mitts on one and lost it.
Yeah, and I don't think that they're going to lose confidence in him, though, because of the track record. Such a good player, maybe having a bad game, but I think they'll still go to him in a critical spot.
And this will split the uprights. It's right down the middle, and that will extend the lead out to 24. So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
That's fielded in the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory... not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
Over the middle, complete. It's Elliott. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. First down, Prescott. It's caught right side, it turns. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. Prescott going to come up first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Eagles are winners here as we say so long from Philadelphia.